New Lands, by Charles Hoyfort, Part 2, Chapter 24d. That a large, substantial mass, presumably of land, can be in at least temporary suspension over a point upon this Earth's surface, and not fall, and be, in ordinary circumstances, invisible. In Law Astronomy, 1887, page 426, Messrs. Codd and Payne, both of them astronomers, well known for their conventional observations and writings, publish accounts of an unknown body that appeared upon the sun's limb, for 20 or 30 seconds, after the eclipse of August 19, 1887. They saw a round body, apparent diameter about 1/10 of the apparent diameter of the sun, according to the sketch that is published. In Law Astronomy, these two observers write separately, and, in the city of Marsilis, their observations were made at a distance apart. But the unknown body was seen by both upon the same part of the sun's limb, so it is supposed that it could not have been a balloon, nor a circular cloud, nor anything else very near this earth. But many astronomers in other parts of Europe were watching this eclipse, and it seems acceptable that others, besides two in Marsilis, continued to look immediately after the eclipse, but from nowhere else came a report upon this object, so that all indications are that it was far from the sun and near Marsilis, but farther than clouds or balloons in this local sky. I can draw no diagram that can satisfy all these circumstances, except by supposing the sun to be only a few thousand miles away.